Continuing with chapter 2, previously we looked at a two-point perspective, and we divided and subdivided on the previous video how to do this. So in this case, what I did, I blew up this area right here, okay? And because sometimes it's much better to do it a little bit bigger than very small, so I blew up that area. And what I'm going to show you now is how you find the vanishing point, okay? So the best way probably is to put another piece of paper. I tape it in this case on the back. I'm gonna put my paper, I'm not gonna tie it up, and I'm just gonna put my paper on the table. I have a T-square, and you can also have just a ruler. And what are you going to do is to find the second vanishing point. In this case will be vanishing point one, and then I named that one vanishing point two. So you're just gonna make a line, continue with the horizon line that you have here. This is the horizon line. And what you're going to do, you're gonna find the vanishing point where all these lines will meet in the horizon, okay? So it's gonna be the back first. Okay. Then it's gonna be the front. It's very important to always keep that vanishing point on sight. So now you can see, for example, where the vanishing point meets the horizon. So it's right here, okay? This I will call vanishing point one. This one is vanishing point two. And remember, this is the horizon line, and this is my box. Now, remember how can I go back into the other vanishing point too, just to make sure. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna trace my lines back into that one. And anything that I draw in this box is gonna follow the path to that vanishing point. Okay? So vanishing point one, vanishing point two. Now, what I normally will do after this, I will put a couple of tracing paper on top. I'll make sure I tape the paper. Now I have the vanishing point one and two, and I will start developing the box, and I will start subdividing it. And after that, I will find a piece of furniture that I think in this case, it's pretty much, you know, just very simple. Normally I do modern furniture because it's easier to have a very simple, you know, develop. It doesn't have too many curves, too many things, too much stuff to, you know, be difficult to draw. So pretty much what I do after I subdivide it, after I kind of proportion this to my piece of furniture, I will save probably that copy ready to develop. As you can see, there's another model here, but it's almost 1.5, so I'll have to redevelop the box and do the couch again. So in that case, we will continue, and I will show you in the next video how to do this step by step.